Have you ever tried to watch a new movie or play a new game and you feel the quality doesn't look perfect? What if you can make it look much better on your TV? In this video, we'll see how to increase picture quality for games and movies, when to use game mode and when to turn it off, testing the input lag for your TV, and a few suggested settings to make your TV look much better. What is game mode on TVs? Game mode is supposed to make input lag less on your TV, and for that, it will disable some image processing to achieve faster response time. Samsung says it's your choice to get a better picture quality or a faster processing, meaning in less input lag. Game mode input lag. This is where the duel starts. I'm connecting controller with USB cable to make sure controller input lag stays the same. This is a side-by-side test, and if I go frame by frame forward to hit the shot button, you can see when the game mode is on. When you do a quick press, you can see on the right side it's already shooting after a few milliseconds, while on the left side it is started 3 frames after that. However, you can find game mode input lag and normal TV lag by going to ratings and look for your TV model. Here you can see in my TV it's really high without game mode. If you are into FPS games or online multiplayer games like Call of Duty or other shooter games, game mode can come in handy. That's why I turn it on for multiplayer games. Game mode image quality test. When you use game mode, image quality may decrease significantly. Also, in some TVs, game mode will disable local dimming, which causes blooming in dark areas. It doesn't look good for movies and also offline games. That's why I turn off when playing story games or watching movies. The same with quality. If I compare a picture of the game which is zoomed in, you may notice quality is lower when using game mode in compared to the normal mode. There's something called ghosting for fast moving objects, which you can see the difference in this test, which I made it in both normal and gaming mode. Remember that I'm testing it with an LED panel. These effects can be different or may not be an issue at all on an OLED panel. You can search and find if your TV is LED or OLED. With all said, when to use game mode? In my opinion, use game mode only when you want to play FPS or online multiplayer games. When you want to play story games, watch movies and TV shows, you can disable it. Some say quality is better with game mode, but they might be mistaken. Most TVs has different settings for outside game mode and game mode. For example, this option, which is contrast enhancer, can make a huge difference. If you have it on game mode, remember to turn it on for normal mode as well. Best TV settings when the game mode is off. When you turn off game mode, you have access to additional settings, for example, Motion Plus in Samsung TVs. You can reduce judder and increase sharpness for games and movies. This is a side-by-side comparison for Motion Plus judder reduction settings, and you can see the game looks better, especially if you play fast game or fast camera movement. However, this game is running at 30 FPS, but with Motion Plus it looks smoother. But be careful, as each of these settings can increase input lag and make response time lower. As you see, when I'm aiming and Motion Plus judder reduction is activated, we have ghosting issues in a 30 FPS game, and it could be so hard to play a game like this. However, it might be different when you are playing 60 FPS games. For example, in this game you can see there is no issue like that. It also depends on your TV panel, and if the CPU and processing is better on your TV, you may likely to see less issues even in a 30 FPS game. Anyway, can you make these settings automatic? Well, Sony is adding ALLM to the PS5, which means the TV understands when you're playing games or watching movies, so it will automatically switch to the game mode only when you are playing games. But I recommend to turn it off by yourself when you want to play offline games. In my opinion, it can be okay while having a little more input lag, and instead you get much better quality. If you watch HDR content, check this video next, and if you want to get the least input lag while playing, check this one next. Links are also in the description and in the comments down below.